Okay, in this video, I want to show you a little bit of the power of the new masks that got introduced in Lightroom Classic 11. And I think that this really is, I mean, and I don't like to use the word that often, but these were really a game changer. In fact, for me, they were probably the most important new feature in Lightroom since Lightroom itself. They are so powerful, but they also are a little bit more complex. So let me show you just a quick example of what you can actually achieve with these. And they really allow you to work in Lightroom and to keep working in Lightroom without having to go to Photoshop for a lot of things that previously you really needed Photoshop for. So in this image, this is a wedding image, obviously, and I didn't shoot it myself. It's a stock photo. I don't shoot a lot of weddings, and especially not weddings where the groom is so excited that he can jump this high. But that's the nice thing about this image is obviously the groom jumping. But the problem is he's, you know, as grooms tend to be, he's in a rather dark suit and the background is also fairly dark. So it doesn't really show that well. And so what I want to do is I want to show you how we can work on this. Now, you've probably seen by now, if you followed the Lightroom news, that one of the main new features is Select Subject. Now, the thing is, Select Subject is what we'll use here, but Select Subject will select what Lightroom thinks is the subject, and in this case, it's the couple. So there is really no way to refine that selection automatically in Lightroom. You can't say select the left subject or select the right subject. And this is a question I get asked a lot. Like, if you have a group portrait of some sort, how can you specify that you only want to work on one specific person in that group portrait? Well, like I said, there's no automated way, but we can still find the path of least resistance. And in this case, what I can do, so you can, what I've created now is basically a mask consisting of one, what we call component. And the component is this here. This is our subject selection. Now, the beauty in Lightroom Classic is that you don't only get these different kinds of tools that you can use, and the new ones of which are Select Sky and Select Subject, but we also have four ways of combining these tools. Like, we have the ability to invert every selection. We also have the ability to add, to subtract, and to intersect. And what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to subtract the bride from my selection. And now the only thing I need to do is click on subtract, and then I need to choose the tool, the selection tool that will work best to that extent. Now, there's all kinds of tools I could use. Like, I could brush her away, and if you're charging by the hour, I would suggest to do that. But if you'd rather keep it, you know, quick, then the most obvious tool, I think, in this case is the linear gradient. Let me show you why. If I choose the linear gradient, well, the only thing I need to do is basically put my, normally you linear gradients, you make them pretty broad because you want to fade into whatever you want to change. But in this case, I really, it's like I want to make a clean cut between right at the junction of their hands here. So I'm going to put my cursor here, I'm going to click, and then I'm going to drag, and I'm going to drag over a very short distance. And I'm going to do it at an angle, something like this here. And I'm going to let go. And in this case, now I need to move it over slightly to here, I think. But as you can see, with this linear gradient, I was able to remove the bride from my selection. And so the final mask is a mask of just the groom jumping because I combined these two components. I subtracted a linear gradient from my automatic subject selection. And now, once I have this selection, I can simply bring up the shadows, for example. I can bring up the exposure, and this will help me to make him stand out more. So it's as easy as that. Now, while I'm at it, I might actually also say, hey, you know, I want to put a little bit more emphasis on the beautiful detail in the bride's dress. So now I need a selection that only selects the bride. Well, we know how to do that. We create a new mask. We choose Select Subject again. And in this case, I'm going to subtract the groom. So again, linear gradient, and I'll just drag my linear gradient from left to right to subtract the groom. Now, the thing is, if I were to increase my texture, right now, you can see it works nicely on the wedding dress, but it also adds too much texture to the skin tones, and we don't really want that, especially when the bride would be facing us. We would definitely not want that. So I need to refine this particular mask a little bit more. And what I want to do is basically I want to subtract, I want to only have a selection of the dress. And the dress is pretty much everything, except there's also the skin tone selection in her. So what I'll do is I'll subtract, and I will subtract a color range from this initial selection, and the color range that I'm going to subtract is exactly the skin tone. So I'll just click and drag out a rectangle, and every skin tone in this selection now gets subtracted, and what you see is basically a very nice selection of only the dress. I could refine this a little bit more if I want to make the selection even slightly better. It didn't get this part of the veil, but I'm okay with that. I could brush over it if I wanted to, but I think that's fine. And now I simply need to increase the texture, maybe even lower the highlights slightly. And as you can see, this is before, after I was able to add more detail into that wedding dress, all while keeping her skin perfectly as it was before. Now, while we're at it, you know, and this can get addictive, this masking, because it's so easy and so much fun. And you know, back in the day, I wouldn't want to dream of doing this in Lightroom. I wouldn't have done this in Lightroom. I would have taken this image immediately to Photoshop and use select subject and masks and curves and whatnot. But this is so much easier, and it also stays within Lightroom, which means that you can synchronize this with other images like this. It's so powerful. Okay, so I'm going to make a final select subject selection, and I'm going to invert this one here, and I'm going to darken. So basically what I've done now is two clicks, I've automatically selected the background of my image, and I can darken this a little bit again, so they stand out more. I can even select him again and maybe bring up the shadows a little bit more still. And what I can also do is not only darken it, but another way to draw less attention to the background and more to the subject is to lower the saturation slightly. And so you see that we could really make our bride and our groom stand out more in this image. This is the before, this is before, this is after, and we used only local masking and moreover only automated or semi-automated local masks in Lightroom Classic. So this is just one example of the incredible power of the new local masks in Lightroom Classic 11. If you want to know more about this, then I would happily invite you to my two-part live online webinar, which is on February 7 and 9. It's two-part. It's going to be like 4 hours in total, depending on the number of questions that you guys have. And I did this already at the end of 2021 in Dutch. The new one's obviously going to be in English, and the Dutch one was one of my best webinars of 2021. So I would suggest, if you only have room and budget and time for one Lightroom training this year, make it this one, because the new masks are so incredibly powerful that I really feel like I need two sessions to tell you everything there is to know about it. I'll cover, I think it's about 50 different examples, ranging from portrait photography, wedding photography, landscape, wildlife, architecture, you name it, it'll be included. And I'm going to show you this whole range of ideas and techniques and combinations until you'll really feel the ultimate power of these new masks. Now, if you say like, hey Pete, I'm super interested, but the timing is a little bit bad for me, or the hours don't really work out, that's no problem. I would still suggest you register at the early bird rate, because every participant also will get a downloadable and streamable version of the recording. So even if you can't make it to the live event, just sign up and, you know, watch it for as long as you can, or even don't watch the live event at all. But you will, in the week following the live event, you will get the downloadable and streamable access to the course. and it will still enable you to lock in that early bird rate. Another advantage of signing in at the early bird rate is that everybody who does so also gets access to a masking preset pack, because one of the cool things you can do with these new masks is turn them into presets, so to speed up your workflow even more. I've got a custom made pack of 10 masking presets with a little extra bonus tutorial in which I explain how to use them, and that's also for people who sign up during the early bird phase of the sign up procedure. So that's about it, what I wanted to show you with this particular image. If you want to see many more images like this, many more examples, just subscribe for the webinar February 7 and 9. I hope to see you there. Thanks for watching, and bye bye.